carving Crazy Horse is an unlikely marriage of the fine arts and explosives engineering on the grand scale.
John's Adventure Vlog presents the Halfmerica Road Trip.
Finally in South Dakota now, we are at the Crazy Horse National Memorial Monument Museum Visitor Center gift shop and, of course, rock sculpture in the background, which when completed will be the largest sculpture in the entire world. At its present state, however, it's only about 15% complete, which considering first went under construction over 70 years ago, is kind of disappointing, but at the same time, it is extremely impressive. You can fit the entirety of Mount Rushmore just in Crazy Horse's head up there. The entire thing was started as an extremely optimistic and overly ambitious project by Korczak Ziolkowski. And so, embodying the quote by Crazy Horse, "My land's where my dead lie buried," this Ziolkowski guy decided, on his own dime, on his own time, single-handedly, began sculpting this thing.
Cutting the tunnel under the arm was the hardest part. When finished, that huge opening could hold a 10-story building.
His 10 children and wife take up the cause today, generations later, and unfortunately, they still have a lot of work in front of them. But since they charged us $20 for admission here, I'm thinking they might have the budget to get this done at some point.
But how do they actually carve a mountain? It's done with drills and explosives, and every blast involves at least 24 separate steps.
It is entirely privately funded. Ziolkowski twice turned down $10 million grants from the government, which is great and also fitting considering Crazy Horse the Indian was stabbed in the back by a government soldier. So to accept money from the government later to make him a memorial seems kind of out of place. It's a really cool looking sculpture. I just want to see it up on the mountain. And right now I can only see the model in here. Even the gift shop and museum here is overwhelming. They're just hundreds and thousands of pieces of Native American artifacts and paintings and blankets and beads and books and pictures. It's great if you love Native American stuff. And I hate to say it, but they're not really exciting or interesting to me, so I'm kind of like, eh. We're now standing in a section of the visitor center where you can see the model of the entire area, a model of just a sculpture, and then the sculpture itself. You get this telescoping view of what everything's going to look like, what the sculpture will look like, and then what it looks like right now at 7 o'clock during sunset. Planning to develop this entire area into university and airport, extremely ambitious. I don't know if it'll ever all get done, but if it does, this will be pretty cool. You find a new friend?
Yeah. Of course I did.
Now this Ziolkowski guy lived alone in the mountains, began carving this 600-foot sculpture, then married and had 10 kids, and kept living in the mountains carving a sculpture until he died. It's pretty normal, right? Despite his, let's say, eccentricities, this guy was clearly an accomplished sculptor. He won the World's Fair with this monument back in the 1930s. And he has plenty of other pieces in this museum that are really great works of bronze and of stone. But again, I'm curious as to what made him think he could just change an entire mountain.
Unfortunately, that does it for this episode of the Adventure Vlog, but stay tuned for the next installment of the Halfmerica Road Trip series, where we visit Mount Rushmore. As always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.